Adriano, thanks to organizer for inviting me. So today I will talk about some recent results that we have obtained in collaboration with Diego Alberici, Pierluigi Contucci from Bologna, and Adriano Barra from Salento University. So, if you want to find some details, there are two papers on the archive. Here is the index. So, basically, here is the outline of the talk. I will introduce the what I mean for deep. Enough. And I will show how to control the annealed region, and I give also a replica symmetric bound. So there are related works on this kind of model in the case of bipartite models when we have only two layers. The first work is by Adriano Barra, Giuseppe Genovese and Guerra. This is the first work, I guess, on the spin glass in bipartite setting. Then there is a work from Arfinger and Chen in the spherical case that actually was completely solved in 2017 by Bake and Lee using random matrix theory. And I want also mention that in the Bayesian, what we call Bayesian optical setting, you can completely solve the model using the technique introduced by Shan, Barbier, Macris, and Milan. Okay. So we will talk about deep, sometimes called restricted Boltzmann machine, introduced by Hinton and Salogodinov in 2009. And we will focus mainly on the deep architecture of this model that we can think as a linear chain of Boltzmann machine. And we look at the model from the point of view of spin glass theory. So we fix the coupling to be quenched and try to understand the phase diagram, basically. So what I will show is a complete characterization of the annealed region and a replica symmetric bound. Okay. So here the definition of the model. So you take N capital N spins, and you arrange them in K capital K layers. The size of the layer P is NP. The capital N is the parameter that controls the thermodynamic limit. And we assume that the relative density here has a well-defined thermodynamic limit with lambda P. So, clearly, you have this condition for the lambda p, which is the sum of lambda p equal to 1. So basically, lambda p belongs to some simplex, k-dimensional simplex. So jij is the coupling between the spin I and j, and we assume that this is a standard Gaussian random variable. And we can also imagine to have some external field acting on the layer p. We have no special requirement on the distribution of the random field, only we have so finite absolute moment. And then we can also, let's say, fix some parameter beta, which is a vector, that basically it's the variance. You can think of beta p as the variance of this jij. Maybe a picture is more clear. So you have this K layer and each spin, the interaction is allowed only between spin from one layer to the L plus to the next one. So we not allow interaction between the same layer. Okay, so the Hamiltonian is defined in this way. So given a configuration of spin, is the sum of all this contribution, which basically is the interaction between the layer P and the layer P plus one. The factor two, it's only for math convenience, as you can imagine. And you see here the role of beta P. You can think of beta P as like a local temperature for the two consecutive layer, okay? So a central object in spin glass theory and for this model in general is the overlap. Here in this case, you have several kinds of spin because you can identify a spin respect to the layer that it belongs. So you have for any P, which is the number of layer, you have the overlap of the system, which is the normalization one over NP, sum over all the sites in the layer, sigma I, tau I, where sigma and tau are two configuration of spins, okay? So the covariance matrix of the Gaussian process with the Hamiltonian, you can think as a Gaussian process, is basically a quadratic form. It's n times, so it's extensive in the volume, which is a good thing, times this object with order one, and this is a quadratic form built up by defining a vector of the overlap, which basically each component is the overlap associated to the P layer. And the quadratic form is associated to this matrix M1, and M1 is defined in this way, where lambda is the vector of the relative density and the matrix M0 is this one. So behind the, let's say, the main characteristics of this matrix is that it's three diagonal, and this is exactly the reason why we can solve, we can say something, let's say, about the annealed and the replica symmetric regime. So if you think in the case of K equal two, which correspond to the bipartite case, you simply have to look at this little minor here, and this corresponds to the bipartite case. So, okay, as usual in statistical mechanics, the first thing to do is to look at the partition function, and much and even more interesting maybe it's the quenched pressure, which is the 1/n, the expectation over all the JHAs of the logarithm of the partition function. So here the partition function is the exponential of the Hamiltonian, and we keep the action of the magnetic field in the measure, if you like, only for convenience, of course. Anyway, we are interested to this object, okay? This is a spin glass model, and the good news and also the bad news, it's that it's not easy to treat with classical spin glass technique. What I mean is that if you try to use interpolation, let's say, for example, to prove the thermodynamic limit, because of this structure of the matrix interaction, you have some problem, because you see that this matrix, for example, in the case K equals two, is not positive defined. So you have some issues if you try to use in the interpolation method in the usual way. Nevertheless, we can still do something. And the idea is that, okay, usually in the interpolation, if you think of the Shearing-Tucker-Patrick model, you compare the two-body interaction, which is the characteristic of the Shearing-Tucker-Patrick model, with some one-body interaction that you can tune a little bit and play. Here we do something a little bit different. We compare the pressure of our model with some convex combination of SK model. With this symbol PSKN, I denote the quenched pressure of a Shearing-Tucker-Patrick model of n particle, where the temperature of this Shearing-Tucker-Patrick model depends on a parameter. One, so there are positive number plus something which is a function of A. So A is my free parameter that I can tune for my convenience later, but you fix A and you define this object, which is basically this part, which is a convex combination of SK models plus something. Here, the temperature of the SK is given by this function theta P of A, which is defined below, okay? What is the point in defining this object is that actually you can prove that this object for any choice of your A free parameter gives a lower bound for the pressure of the deep Boltzmann machine. Okay, just an idea to how to prove this inequality. You do an interpolation between your model, the deep Boltzmann machine with K layers, and then you take K independent Sherrington-Kirkpatrick models. Then you do interpolation and you can control the derivative observing that this object is always positive. Okay, clearly you have to play a little bit with constant, but it's not hard to show this inequality. And this basically is the starting point of the work, because the idea is that, okay, since now we have, let's say, a good control of what happened to the pressure of the SK model, so we can control the left-hand side by controlling the right-hand side. So in particular, you can choose A to infer something about the pressure of the deep Boltzmann machine. So the first thing that you can do is to completely characterize the annealed region in this way. So first, you set the external field equal to zero, and just the definition of the annealed pressure, instead of taking the expectation of the logarithm, you take the logarithm of the expectation of the partition function. This is the definition of annealed pressure, clearly because Z is the sum of Gaussian, this can be computed exactly. It actually is independent on N and has this expression. And also by Jensen inequality, you have that this object is always greater than the pressure of the model. Notice that here I put the limb soup instead of the limb, because actually we are not able to prove the existence of the limit of this object. This is the reason is the same that I just mentioned before, because the matrix that tune the overlap, the covariance matrix of the project, is not positive defined. Okay, so you cannot apply a Guerra-Toninelli argument, something like that. So we say that the system is in the annealed regime if the pressure of the model, the quenched pressure of the model, equals the annealed one. Okay, this is just the definition. And as I mentioned, we have to exploit the control of the annealed region of the SK model, because if you remember here, in the red right-hand side of this inequality, there is a convex sum of SK models. So just to remember what happened for the SK model, there is this result, which I guess it's the first rigorous result on the SK model due to Eisenman, Leibovitz, and Ruelle, which is the pressure, the quenched pressure of the SK model equals the linear one for beta small enough. So for high temperature regime, this is the result for the SK model. Then you can use it to control the right hand side of this inequality. Notice that the annealed pressure is always an upper bound. The annealed pressure is always an upper bound for P dBm. Here you have the reverse inequality, so it's reasonable to hope for something. In fact, what you can obtain is that if you consider the system of this system of inequality, and you define this subset of the space parameter, which is basically all the beta lambda, beta, remember, is the collection of local temperature, lambda is the relative density, which belongs to some simplex, such that there is a solution for A for this system. So this is my set capital A, and I denote by the bar capital A is the topological closure of AK. What you can prove if you take a point in the phase diagram beta lambda that belongs to this set, then you have equality between quenched and annealed pressure. Okay.
Lale, sorry if I interrupt you. You have just roughly a minute.
I have just?
Roughly a minute. You are running out of time.
Okay. So very quickly, this condition for AK, it's very implicit because you see it's a mess, if you like. Anyway, there is an interesting connection between this region AK and some matching polynomial that comes from monomer dimer models. So basically the condition that beta lambda belongs to AK is equivalent to some other condition that are more explicit in the parameter beta lambda. So again, exploiting the fact that now we have a good control on the SK model, we can use the previous bound to obtain a lower bound, which is given in terms of a replica symmetric functional. But the point is that this bound is not doesn't hold in all for all the choice of the parameter beta lambda h, but only in a suitable region that you can determine. This suitable region is basically the analogous of the Almeida-Thales condition for the SK model. So very quickly, I go in the definition of the replica symmetric function. So this is the function that you have to look if you, this is the replica symmetric function that you obtain simply comparing your model with some one-body interaction. And the stationary condition is this one. Recently has been proved by Genovese that actually this condition is obtained by a min-max procedure. And the main theorem is that under some condition on the parameter beta lambda h of the phase diagram, this replica symmetric function is a lower bound for the thermodynamic limit of the pressure. Okay, so I can stop here if I have, because actually the last two slides are only corollary of this main theorem. Because again, this is not so explicit, but if you work a little bit, you can find conditions that are more explicit in the space of the parameter. So that's all.
Okay, thanks a lot.